Hello everyone, what is cooking all you good looking people out there, and welcome to another exciting episode of GeoGuessr. Here we are in yesterday's daily challenge location. Big open grassy plains, beautiful big night skies, and well, not very much to see, but I guess that's the point. I mean, stars is actually quite a lot to see, if you think about it. Like, there's a lot of them, right? That really does beg the question, where in the world are we? And that's what it's all about. It's time for me to guess where I think this is. And I'm going to say that we're in America, in the big open plains of what state? Of Wyoming. And we're going to say we are south of Grand Teton National Park. We're going to go with that. And yeah, we're going to say we're south of it, sort of like right down in here. We make the guess, and the answer was we were south of it, and we were in Wyoming, the best state. But we were actually over here in, right near Lander Cutoff Road. All right. Well, there you go. 3155. Wyoming isn't the best state, but it may be the most beautiful state. It very well could be. It's a contender, although no one really thinks about it. But there's other good states. I mean, Colorado, Utah, lots of other ones. But pretty much all around here. I mean, you could say California, too, actually. That's probably one of the most beautiful. You can say Florida as well, actually. There's a lot of really... You can say Hawaii as well, or Alaska. So there's a lot of beautiful states. 3155. Hopefully some of you guys figured that one out. All right, here we are in today's daily challenge, and today we've got a place where I would love to take a swim. Wow, I'm just kidding. I would not like to take a swim here at all. Look at this. This looks very corrosive. I don't know. It looks like if you jumped in this, you would definitely die. And if you drank the water, you would also definitely die. I don't know what it contains or where it is. Also, this weird rock formation is also very strange. You know, this is probably one of those places where I just don't know where it is, but it's like a big international landmark that I've never heard of. So maybe it'll be just obvious to many of you where this is. But for me, this is just like, wow, what a weird place. Let's get a bulldozer out. Bulldoze over this whole thing, lay down some concrete, and turn this into a parking lot, because really, this is just an abomination. But hey, you know what, maybe it is a place that is somewhat important or nice. I don't know. But hey, if you guys have any idea where this is, all you need to do is put your guesses down in the comment section below. Tell me where in the world you think we are, and in tomorrow's video's comment section, I announce the winner, the person that guesses closest. Now, there are no prizes, but there is glory to be won. So if you are interested in becoming today's top GeoGuessr, then tell me, where in the world do you think we are right now? All right, here we are in the main section of today's video, and today we've got a viewer challenge. A viewer challenge brought to us by none other than our good friend, Lance and Derek. That's right. Thank you so much for sending this challenge in. Now, this challenge has an interesting theme. It is about the lesser-known battles of World War II. So that is really cool, because World War II is one of those things, I really like the theme, and it's one of those things that, I never know enough about. So it's always good to learn more, this is about lesser-known battles, so I expect me to know about none of them. Maybe I'll get really lucky and have heard of one. It's going to be like general ideas. Like, I'll probably know that there was stuff that happened here, but I won't know what that stuff is or any stories about it. But I've got my phone over here, and Lance and Derek has been nice enough to write me a little paragraph about each location. So after we figure out where we are, then I'll read the paragraph. So thank you so much, Lance and Derek, for sending this one in. If you're interested in creating your own custom challenge, all you need to do, look down in the description below, find a step-by-step guide on how to create your own custom challenge and how to send it to me. Also, you can find a link to this one so you can play along yourself. So let's do it. All right. This is going to be... I was actually very confused looking at this. This is going to be something like... Norway? Iceland? I don't know. Where are we? Interesting. What does this say? This says, that is Iceland, right? Iceland? Oh, wow. There was fighting in Iceland. Wow. I did not know that at all, actually. That's really interesting. Iceland. The stuff that happened in World War II in Iceland. Huh. Wow, that is actually really interesting. There's a there's the dual bucket for is Kroner. Is that? Oh yeah, Iceland. Okay. Oh, there you go. So very, very cool. Let us move around and take a little bit of a look at this city. I don't know where this is, but this is definitely not Reykjavik, and I also don't think it's Akureyri. I think this one, if I had to guess, is, oh boy, which is the main city over here? Is it the F city or the R city? I thought it was the F city. No, maybe it's just Vic down over here. There is like a main city over here. I just don't know which one it is. One of these is sort of populated, isn't it? I really thought one of them was, but I have no idea which one it could be. There's too many now. Hold on, where does the boat go? The boat goes down to there. This is actually a really big city. So, what about up here? No. Okay, let's return to start location. Let me see. Maybe it will be Akureyri. It's not. Oh, jeez. What city is it going to be then? What about this city right here? Yeah, that's where I'm guessing. I'm going to guess right here. All right. Make the guess, and the answer is yes, indeed. 6452. So let's read a little bit about this. First location is in Iceland. The battle that took place, battle is in quotes, here was the British invasion of the island in order to deny Iceland to the Germans. The British invaded with a force of 746 men and took no casualties apart from one who killed himself. This took place on the 10th of May, 1940. So the British kind of invaded to make sure the Germans wouldn't get it. Makes sense. 6452. Okay. Well, what about this location? Huh. Wow, I had no idea that ever happened. You think the people of Iceland now, when they look back at that happening, are thankful for the this invasion by Britain? Or maybe feel it was completely unnecessary? Or are pissed off about it? I don't know. How did the people of Iceland look at this event in history? It's a really good question. But wherever we are now, it seems that we are in Australia. Okay, so something happened in Australia. All right. Something happened in Australia. Really, did it? Well, actually, you know what? That makes sense, if you think about it. I mean, there was a hell of a lot of fighting here. I mean, the fighting got close to Australia, right? So That definitely, you know, people must have been worried in Australia that something would have happened, right? You'd think so. Maybe not, but I have no idea because you never really think about how close Australia really is to, like, a lot of fighting that happened. So, maybe. Do I think we're going to be up in... Is this really Australia, first of all? I'm, like, 40% sure it is, but that's not very much. What do we got here? NTS. Northern Territories. It is. All right. So we're in Darwin. Interesting. Darwin, Australia. All right. Make the guess, and the answer is yes. So the second location is Darwin, Australia, where the Japanese launched their first bombing raid against Australia. Really? Wow. I have no idea that happened. This would be followed by further 96 raids across Northern Australia over the course of the war. Wow, just Northern Australia. I did not know that the Japanese did bombing raids in Australia. First attack was very successful, taking place on 19th February 1942. It sunk ships, destroyed 30 aircraft, and killed 400 people. Wow. That is really interesting. I have never heard about this. It's really cool. Really cool. Really interesting. Really interesting indeed. 6369. Okay. Oh, what about this next location? Where is this going to be? Well, I don't know where that is. Oh boy, this is not going to... This one I'm not going to do very well on. Well, ooh, this is going to be a really tricky one. This is going to be a really tricky one. I was thinking, like, that this would be, like... I was thinking India, then I thought Bangladesh, then I thought not Bangladesh. Maybe Myanmar? Maybe. Maybe India, still. Maybe, I don't know where else. I don't think we're going to be in this area over here of the world. Wow. I really, really don't know where to even guess. Should I just guess Myanmar? I guess I should. I mean, I don't know if I should, but where do I really think this is? I mean, I've really got nothing on this one. Vietnam? No. Laos? Well, definitely after the war. Cambodia? A lot of stuff happened there too. But I don't know. I mean, I feel like so, like this would make sense, but maybe so, maybe not. I don't know. Philippines? No, I don't think that's where we are. And the language, what I can see, that's not Vietnamese. I really don't know. Maybe it is India. Maybe it is India, because I don't see any other kind of writing that would really indicate to me where we are. Now, let's go Myanmar. Let's make it fun. All right, right there. The answer was, okay, kind of. Closer to Myanmar than where you normally think of when you think India. It was on the right track, I guess. Wow, look at that. Imphal. Okay, well, let's learn about this one. Third location is Imphal, India. This was the furthest Japanese forces reached in India. They reached this point in 1942 and tried to push on, but could not break through stubborn Indian and British resistance. In 1944, Indian British counterattack decisively defeated Japanese forces and caused over 50,000 casualties. The Japanese would be pushed back to the pushed back for the rest of the war. Wow. 50,000 casualties. It's the kind of thing, like, those are the kind of numbers you don't realize when you think about World War II. Like, you forget 50,000 people die in one battle. 50,000 people. That is insanity, right? I mean, you know, when was the last time that, I mean, over the course of what? It was what? It was in 1944 counterattack. Did 50,000 people die over the course of how long, right? When was the last time 50,000 people died? 50,000 people died yesterday, Aether. Oh, well, okay. Well, that's not what I meant. Well, I guess, you know, if you think about it that way, you know, it's only 100% more. Well, I mean, I don't know how many people died yesterday, but I'm guessing more than 50,000. 2352. Jeez. Craziness. All right. What about this place? There was something that happened here. Oh, you know, I've seen this location before. I forget where it was, though. Where the hell was this? Where was this again? This was in Alaska. Oh, yeah, this was in Alaska, if I remember correctly. Wasn't it? It was right around here. So something actually happened close to this place. This was like around, like in here or something, wasn't it? I think it might have been. I feel like it was, but I might be wrong. I might be thinking of another location. Because I've seen this. I chose it at one of the locations for a daily challenge one time. But, you know, this is not just cool locations across the world. This is locations where World War II stuff happened. So something happened here. Well, maybe that explains this. Maybe this is related to World War II. Maybe not. I think it was somewhere like along the lines of there. No, it was actually all the way down here. Really? That was all the way down here? Okay, I don't remember that. But okay, if you say so. Fourth location is one of the Aleutian Islands of Alaska. In 1942, my God, the Japanese really did a lot in 1942. The Japanese invaded the most westernly islands, Attu and Kiska, to lure some of the American fleet away from Midway, which was about to be attacked. However, American code breakers knew it was only a diversion and kept their fleet together in Midway, winning the battle there. The islands were recaptured on August 1943.
Wow. That is actually really interesting. Wow, so the Japanese took over some of these islands here. I mean, it's interesting, right? I mean, that's the kind of thing. Like, you don't even hear about, like, what the Japanese... I mean, much of what the Japanese did. In fact, you barely hear about what the Japanese did in Korea and China. You don't really hear much about that either. When you think about it, like, you probably hear a lot more about, like, you know, Hawaii and Midway and the battle for the Pacific and stuff like that in the Philippines. But you don't hear too much about what Japan was doing in Korea and China at the time. And other places, I'm sure. I mean, that's really interesting. You really don't hear about that. I mean, you hear a lot about what Germany did in all sorts of countries and stuff. But you don't hear about what Japan was doing. I mean, the only thing that you really hear of is Japan attacked America. I mean, that's not really the only thing you hear. But, I mean, it's mostly what you hear. I mean, to think about it, if Japan hadn't done that, they probably would have gotten away with it. If America here's a good question. Who was in a war with Japan out of countries that are not in Asia? And I don't even think that, you know, I don't really know if Austria, who was first to, other than, you know, countries around Japan or countries in Asia, let's say, but not counting Russia. Well, actually, counting Russia, I guess, is what I mean. Who was the first to go to war against Japan? Was it America? Maybe. And if America hadn't, would anyone really have? Like, if Japan hadn't attacked America, would anyone have really gone to war against them? The answer is maybe no, maybe yes. I don't know. I'm not a war historian. This is a question I'd like answered. 2104. All right, where's the next location? All right, this is, well, it depends where this is. It really depends where this is. Because, I mean, if this is, I really don't know where this is. What country do I think this is? There's an interesting, the language is interesting. Orange money. See, this is interesting because Telmo. Let's say Telmo. Or Telma. That doesn't help me. I was hoping it was Telmo because maybe we could be in Mozambique. But I'm not really sure where we are. If this was, let's say, in South Africa, I would be honestly quite surprised because I didn't think that the fighting in Africa took place so south, but I don't think it is. I really don't know where this is. I have no idea what country this is. I mean, I could guess one that's pretty far north, but it's not going to do me any good. This is battles that we don't often hear or think about. And this is, I really don't know where this could be. Huh. I don't have, well, that's not going to help me too much, unfortunately. Let's go, Madagascar, Telma, Madagascar. Ooh, that'd be surprising, wouldn't it? All right, let's guess we're right over here. Make the guess, and the answer was, yes, it was Madagascar. There you go. We were actually in this city over here, but let's find out about it. The final location is Madagascar. Similar to the invasion of Iceland, the British were worried that the pro-German French government, the Vichy regime, would allow the Japanese control of the island. The British invaded the 1942 with significant help from Indian and South African troops and managed to successfully capture the island and install a pro-British French government. Very nice. 2373. So I wonder what the people of Madagascar feel about that. Interesting. 2373. Very, very cool. Wow, what a challenge. My God, learned a lot of cool things. Started off in Iceland. Learned that something happened there. Started off in Australia. Learned that bombings happened there. Found out that this was how far Japan pushed across China, I'm guessing. Wow, that is really far, actually. I didn't think it was that far. Then D. How far in China did they get? That's really interesting. Alaska. Something happened there, too. Japan captured some islands. And then Madagascar. Wow, that is very interesting. 19650. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. I know I certainly have. And as always, I'll see you guys next time.
Aw, yeah. Cue the royalty-free music. 3, 2, 1, go. Come on, everybody. Get on your feet. Stand up, look at the screen, and repeat. I'm gonna like, rate, comment, and subscribe. I love watching AetherVids all of the time. Thanks for dropping by and spending the time. Hope you've enjoyed, and let's get on with our lives. Oh yeah. Thanks to Kevin MacLeod for these awesome beats. Ooh yeah. Have a good one. Bye!